Legend. Mr. Big Joe.
Hey, hey. My brother. You know, black folks is a mess, aren't they? Y'all run around talking about black-on-black crime. And you know, you white folk got to listen to black folk because they be saying things about y'all, and y'all don't even know it. That's right. You heard them talking about black-on-black crime, and then you ask the Negro, what's black-on-black crime? We tired of black folks killing black folks. You heard that, right? They didn't say they tired of black folk killing. And you black folks fall for it. We go to China tonight. Who you think killing Chinese in China? We go to Italy tomorrow. Who you think killing Italians in Italy? And if 98% of white folks that was murdered in America last year was murdered by white folks, if they ain't talking about white on white crime, why you talking about black on black crime? Huh? You kill where you live. Hmm? Aren't you glad about that? And if you black folks is tired of black folk killing black folk, then join the NAACP, SCLC. Get out here with all the civil rights movement. Joe, you know what I'm talking about. And integrate this country. And I guarantee you, if I'm living in this white suburban neighborhood and my old lady make me mad enough to want to shoot somebody, I ain't gonna get in my car and drive back to the ghetto. In the military, in the army. I was in there for 3 days. Why y'all laughing? I might have got wounded. 50,000 of us standing out there, white dude up on the platform saying, if you get captured by the enemy, give up nothing but name, rank, and seal number. Y'all understand? And 50,000 people say, yeah, baby, we understand. You know what it feel like, 50,000 people? And you the dumb, I say, said, what's wrong with you, stupid? I said, I might be, but I do not understand what you say. And another thing, you black folks have to stop trying to act intelligent when you ask white folks a question. So I said to him, I said, Kumita, did you say, captured by the enemy, I'm not both giving up, but name, right, seal number? And that's what I said, boy. Do you ladies know what dog tags are? Yes. And on the dog tags is your name, rank, and seal number, right? So how in the hell are you gonna tell me if I get caught, I can't give up nothing but name, rank, and seal number, the enemy could get that much information if I was dead? I said, no, y'all got to give me something to negotiate with. You know what I'm saying? If you're the enemy, you capture me, right? You got to keep me till the war's over. You got to feed me, you understand? You got to take care of me. If my leg broke, you got to fix my leg. And they're telling me, I can't give you no more than you could get if I was dead? So then white boy said, well, you a traitor. I said, no, no, no. My third day in the military, I'd have been a traitor had I not told you. Call the Pentagon right now and put on my record. If Dick Gregory ever get caught, y'all change all your used-to-be secrets. You know what I'm talking about, don't you, sister? That's the biggest problem I have with my wife when we got married. She couldn't handle debt. When we gonna pay Sears and Roebuck? We. When we gonna pay Sears and Roebuck? Why? They knew I wasn't gonna pay for that stuff when I got it. You think all that credit you black folks, you think you really trick white, but they know you ain't gonna pay for it. Why y'all getting upset? Amen. 2 weeks later, I walk in the house, she upset. Here's a letter from Sears and Roebuck, final notice, final notice. I looked at it and said, huh, thank God we won't be hearing from you no more. My brother called me. They about to repossess my car. What must I do? Don't park in front of the house. saying? I mean, I remember the early days of the Civil Rights Movement. Walked down the street scared, didn't know what was going to happen, and now look where we are. I never thought I'd see today that this thing would get so mellow that white folks would start asking me to comment on white folk problems. I came back in from Europe last month, CNN. Mr. Gregory, you think we'll ever catch Bin Laden? I say, we. I ain't looking for him. I'm still trying to find out who my daddy is. Bob Hope, a lot of you young folks don't remember Bob Hope. Bob Hope lived to get 104. He died at 3:00 in the morning. AP called me, Mr. Gregory, Bob Hope just died. Can we get a comment on you? I said, I thought he'd been dead. So what'd you say? I said, my comment is Bob Hope's family should go to Chicago and get on their knees and kiss Jesse Jackson's feet. Because for 40 years, Jesse been yelling, keep Hope alive. And he's the only comic that lived to get 104. I saw Jesse the other day. Jesse said, Brother Greg, now that Bob Hope has died, let me pray for you. How you gonna run around talking about keep Dick alive? So I leave you just remember, brothers, how smart these sisters are. You know what I'm saying? When Kobe Bryant got busted, remember that? And he went accused of raping a white woman, remember? And he went home and bought his wife a $4 million diamond ring, right? Let me tell you something. If a white woman accused me of raping her tonight, and I go home and buy Lil a $4 million diamond ring, she'll go get two more white women. Because she know wherever that ring came from, there's a matching necklace and bracelet. So, as I leave, brothers, don't underestimate the sister. My little grandson, he all this Cialis talking about erection. My 4-year-old child, he walked up to me and said, Granddad, what's an erection? I said, go ask your grandmother. And he came back smiling. I said, she tell you? She said, no, she'll tell me later. But for me to tell you, she haven't seen one of them things around the house in years.
Ladies and gentlemen, the legend himself, Dick Gregory.